Hello, and welcome to this video on the criteria for selecting a MOOC platform on which to place your course. Now, before we start, I'd like to just draw your attention to a few issues. This might be quite a simple process because you may be able to quickly rule out a lot of options. There may be no need to make this very complicated. But why are we doing this? There may be some key issues that you mightn't think of. So we feel it's our responsibility to bring to your attention all the criteria that might have an impact on your choice. The other thing is, we don't want this to delay your project. We would suggest that you quickly select a platform and move on, if even just to build a prototype of your course. Okay, so let's look at the criteria or the issues involved in selecting a platform. First of all, we'd like to look at platform functionality. Now, you could look at the different platforms and just score them based on the amount of functionality they have. However, it is more likely that there is specific functionality that you're looking for and that you must have that on the platform. And you may be able to rule out platforms on the fact that they don't have that functionality. So let's have a look at some of the more specific functionality. You may not want to store videos on your platform. You may want to put them up on a public platform like YouTube to save on storage. Can you embed them in your course? Can you put quizzes in there? You may want learners to assess each other's learning, to assess each other's submissions. So you may want peer assessment. That's a relatively recent development, and not all platforms have it. Most platforms will have discussion forums. Platforms built for learning anyway will have discussion forums, but you may be able to link to other platforms like Facebook on which people can have their discussions there. Enabling group work can be difficult in a MOOC, and not a lot of people actually want to do that. But if you do want to do it, you may have to look to see if your platform has any functionality there. Is your platform able to analyze large amounts of data to help you, possibly identifying problems in particular parts of your course? Can it track progress? Probably in a large course with a lot of people in it, it's more important that the learner be able to track their own progress. Can you issue certificates based on performance in the course? What about payments? Now, MOOCs are open courses where people don't have to pay. However, you may attach certain certification to this, which requires a bit of effort on your part. Maybe the instructors look at the assignments and grade them, in which case you might like to have a payment. Does the platform have facility for making those payments? If the certification that you're going to give is quite a powerful certification or important certification that your institution wants to stand over, can you verify the identity of the people taking the tests? What about capacity? The capacity to store materials, if you want to store all the materials on that platform. What about its ability to deliver the materials to the learner, the bandwidth of the platform, and its resulting performance if there are a lot of people using it? What about if people are living in areas where it's difficult to get broadband? Will they be able to download the materials and watch them offline? Are there any restrictions on the number of users of the platform? This may not be an issue if you're just building a prototype with a small number of users. Is it the total number of users that might enroll in the course, or maybe the number of users who can be on at the same time? What about access rights? Now, normally, most people will get away with two levels of access rights, those for the author and the regular user or regular learner. The author has complete rights to delete and to add content. The regular user has much more limited rights. They can't change anything in the course. They may be able to contribute to discussion forums. But there may be other types of users that you'd like to have there, whether just for beta testing it or maybe just for a guest access to view the course. Are there any legal issues involved? If you think that privacy or data protection or copyright are issues for you, it might be worthwhile reading the small print of the platform that you're going to use. Usability. Now we can look at this from two points of view: usability for the course author or usability for the learners. For the course author, probably the most important question is, what skills do you have? Have you any previous experience? Are you particularly good with computers? It probably is as well to avoid platforms that are difficult to use. Are there help materials available for you? Have you used a platform before? But of course, if you're dealing on a massive scale with a lot of learners, the usability for the learners is very important too. Is there help there for the learners? Is there possibly an orientation module? What about mobile if the learners are accessing on a mobile? Does it display it exactly as it displays it on a large screen, or is it able to reconfigure it to be suitable for a mobile device? What about people that may have some impairment, accessibility? They may be visually or hearing impaired. Costs. Now this is low cost development of MOOCs we're talking about here. We're not necessarily talking about no cost development of MOOCs, although we believe that's possible as well. So if you do have some money, you may be able to spend it to get a slightly better service. How much is it going to cost you for the hosting? Are they going to charge you for extra storage if you store a lot of materials in there? But probably the most important question in costs is about marginal cost per user. Whereas you may be prepared to spend a small amount of money on putting the course up there, if you get a very large amount of users, you may not be able to afford extra marginal costs if they're significant per user. What about how easy it is to get your hosting service set up? If it's in the cloud, it can be quite easy to use. You can often just register and create a course. However, if you have to do it yourself in your own web space, and there are free software available like Moodle or edX, and you can download the software and set it up in your own web space, how easy is it to do that? Have you got the skills to do that? If you decide you're not going to use a learning platform, but you're just going to build a website, and you may have a mashup with some other services as well, how easy is it for you to set that up? A lot of this depends on your own skills. An important criteria to consider when hosting your site is its visibility. How are people going to find your MOOC? If you use your own website or use your own platform, it may be difficult for people to find that. You're going to have to do a lot of marketing. Whereas if you use a hosting service that has lots of other MOOCs on it, this may be a place where people actually go to look for MOOCs. It also may be a place where MOOC aggregators, that is services that collect information about lots of MOOCs, it may be a place where these MOOC aggregators look to find out about MOOCs, and that may be a way of making your MOOC more visible. What constraints are there on you using the platform? If you're using somebody else's platform, will they check the quality of your course? Will they check what you're doing and have to give you the green light, or do they give you complete freedom to do what you like? Are there legal constraints? Do they reserve rights over the material that you put up there? Again, these may be legal issues, and it may be worthwhile you reading the small print. Okay, what about your target audience? Is there something different about your target audience that may make one platform more suitable than another? This may be a general education course. It could be a course for customers of yours to train them in a product that you have, or it could be a course that you're using to market something. These may have effect on your platform because there may be certain functionality that you don't need, and it may actually make it simpler for you to get a platform. Okay, thank you very much for listening. Bye.